when I would make notes and charts, sometimes I would come across some pretty goofy notes. But obviously, if somebody was a little bit tired or exhausted or overworked, kind of a reminder that we live in a time when people are feeling exhausted and overworked and stressed out. Well, later on, I came across a list of these types of sayings that somebody else had compiled. And so these are some actual notes found in hospital charts. The first one, the patient refused the autopsy. Next note, patient recovering from forehead cut, patient being very angry when given an enema by mistake. Patient has chest pain if she lies on her left side for over a year. On the second day, the knee was better, and on the third, it disappeared. The patient has been depressed since she began seeing me in 1993. She is numb from her toes down. Patient was alert and unresponsive. Patient has two teenage children, but no other abnormalities. So no doubt these are written by somebody who is feeling probably tired or frazzled or exhausted. But doesn't that describe how many of us feel in our society today? Maybe it even describes you as you're sitting here this morning. You know, there's this great scene in the movie, What About Bob? Bob, who's played by Bill Murray, was upset because his psychologist, played by Richard Dreyfuss, was going on vacation. So the psychiatrist pulled out his prescription pad, and Bob said, no more pills, I have enough pills at home. And the doctor said, these aren't pills. And so then he handed Bob a slip of paper that said, I'm on vacation. And he said, Bob, from this moment on, you are on vacation. Not a vacation from your job, not a vacation from your daily life, but a vacation from your problems. Every time a problem comes up, every time you start to get worried, you pull this prescription out and tell yourself, I am on a vacation. I'm not going to worry about it. Doctor's orders. Now, of course, that's just a movie. But today, we're talking about someone who really does pass out a prescription like this. In verse 27 of the gospel reading today, we basically hear Jesus say, hey, I'm the only person who has been entrusted with what it takes to bring you into a personal relationship with God. So come to me if you're weary or if you're burdened, and I will give you rest. Jesus invites us to bring our burdens. And as I'll explain in a few minutes, one of the ways we do that is by developing close relationships with fellow people of faith. And through those friendships, we learn how to share what's really on our hearts, both the highs of the day and the lows of the day. Now, usually when we think about rest, we might think about, you know, just taking a break. Maybe we don't have to shovel the snow, or we don't have to rake the leaves, or we don't have to mow the grass, or just sitting down after a long day of work. And that's definitely an important part of being restful. But what Jesus is saying is that Jesus gives us rest from our worries and from our anxieties. Now, if you're like me, as you're winding down summer and gearing up for this fall, it seems like summer just flew by it. Right next to you. Maybe you had all sorts of plans for where you wanted to go and things you wanted to do. But now that summer's over, you're thinking, wow, I just did not get the rest I thought I was going to get. Maybe you even did go on some of those adventures. Maybe you traveled to some exciting, out-of-the-way locations. But still, you didn't get the rest. So this morning, we're talking about vacation, a real vacation, and real rest. Rest from worries, rest from anxieties, and rest by learning how to share those things of our life with fellow people of faith. Now, first of all, we want to remember that in the Bible, we hear that even Jesus needed a vacation. He only had 3 years in his adult ministry to change the entire universe. And he still got away. He often withdrew to secluded places to pray. As hectic as his schedule was, he took time to find rest for his soul, to be alone with God in prayer. And other times, he spent time away with his three closest friends, Peter, James, and John, to talk with them, to share with them. Now, nobody in the world could claim that Jesus' work was pointless, or that he had a lot of free time, or that things just went all nice and easy for him. Not at all. He dealt with huge challenges and struggles and opposition, and yet he found time to rest. Well, we all have our own problems. Of course, we have challenges and struggles and opposition of our own in one form or another. I mean, there's somebody here today, I'm sure, who's feeling completely burnt out. You've been working so many hours and doing so many different things for people that you're sitting in this pew right now, you're totally exhausted, and quite frankly, this sermon might be that only moment during the week when you get a chance to drift away and talk. Well, Jesus is saying to you, come to me, all you who are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. There's probably somebody here today who has had a pretty stormy home life. It seems like you're fighting with your husband, or your wife, or with the kids. You're fighting with your girlfriend, or your boyfriend, or with the neighbors, fighting with the homeowners association, or with the landlord. Maybe you even find yourself fighting with God. And you're longing for a family atmosphere free from all fighting and friction and frustration. Jesus says to you this morning, come to me, all you who are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. There's also probably somebody here today who's feeling like you've been treated a little unfairly. Somebody said something to you that was just so ridiculous. Maybe they promised to do something and they never got around to doing it. And it's starting to beat you up inside. It's weighing down on you. It's making you feel exhausted. Jesus is saying to you, come to me, all you who are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Whatever it is that's your burden this morning, know that Jesus doesn't want you to hang on to that burden. He doesn't want you walking around in a pall of sadness. Jesus doesn't want you trying to navigate life while carrying all this heavy baggage. He invites you, he says, to come to him, to give your burden to the one person who can actually do something about it, to the one person who can help you take your vacation from your problems. So please don't waste this opportunity you've set up over the next 40 days to sit with other people and share your heart with them. Now, I realize that might sound a bit uncomfortable. I mean, you know, let's face it, we're not used to doing that. But it's what's good for us. That's exactly how we learn to share our burdens with Jesus. And yes, it does take a bit of practice. But Jesus doesn't want us to go through life alone, to go through life without a moment to take a vacation. Problems and burdens. He wants us to hear that phrase, come to me, all you who are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. But there's another side of this too. Jesus wants us to be able to share our joys with one another. And that's why we're not just talking about sharing our lows, but our highs as well, highs and lows. I mean, you might have had something wonderful, something awesome happen this week. Joy is better to be shared too. And life is better when we share that joy together. Sharing those great moments with others, well, that's how we celebrate even more. So again, we use this 40 days in worship and in small groups to learn how to be there with others and for others and to celebrate with others. You know, I was thinking if you use an alarm clock to wake up in the morning, you probably know what a snooze button is. And when the alarm goes off, you can hit the snooze button and get just a few more minutes of sleep. Well, there's two problems with a snooze button. First, if we continue to hit the button, we might wind up being late for something. I mean, after all, we set the alarm for a reason. And second, if we keep on hitting the snooze button, we may get so used to the sound of the alarm that we don't hear it at all. This morning, during this 40 days of community, I'm asking that you not hit the snooze button. please don't decide to wait until it seems like you can find the time to be with other people of faith, but rather make the time, because it matters. I do realize we could be doing a million other things on Saturday nights or Sunday mornings or whatever. We could be golfing. We could be watching TV, even though the games really don't come on usually until about 1 o'clock. We could be sleeping. But by being here, we're choosing a better path. By being in worship, we're choosing to make contact with our Creator. By being in a small group, even if just for a few weeks, we're choosing to make contact with our sisters and brothers in Christ. By taking part in this way, we are choosing a better path of life. A relationship with Jesus Christ and friends from church is the most restful vacation we can ever take.